Hey guys, it's the Villaman here, and today I have a comparison that has been a long time coming. It's a three-way Dolby Atmos shootout. We're talking upfiring, elevation, and in-ceiling speakers. So stick around. So let's dive into some details about these speakers for the comparison. So first up is the Pioneer Elite Andrew Jones designed upfiring speakers. I bought these towers in 2016 and they were my first introduction to Dolby Atmos. Now these are some great speakers even if we don't consider the Dolby Atmos portion. Next up is the SVS Prime Elevations. I have these in for review, which will be live in the coming week. Then lastly is the Martin Logan Electromotion IC in-ceiling speakers. Now I installed these in early 2018 and I've been enjoying them ever since. I'll link that video up there if you want to see it. Now this will be a quantitative and qualitative comparison, and to do that I'll be giving my personal experience and also doing some measurements with the UMIC 1 from Mini DSP. Now first up I'll be using Dolby's Leaf demo because that is a very nuanced and subtle Dolby Atmos demo and it has a lot of movements overhead. I'll also be using Ready Player One because it has an amazing Dolby Atmos soundtrack. It has a lot of low and high frequency effects overhead. I also used it in my Apple TV 4K versus 4K Blu-ray comparison video I did, and I liked it then, so one more time. Oh, and I'm also recording all my videos now in 4K HDR, so you'll be able to watch it in HDR on the iPhone 10 or above, or the newer Android devices, and your 4K HDR TVs, of course. But let me know how it looks on your device, even if it doesn't support HDR. So I recommend using some headphones to listen to this because I want to see if you can identify which speaker you're listening to. But enough talking, let's get to it. Okay, so now I'll show you all three speakers playing the same scene in the movie. Both the in-ceiling and elevation speakers are crossed over at 80 Hz. While the upfiring speaker is crossed over at 200 Hz. And of course, I reran the Odyssey calibration for each run. Each speaker will be labeled A, B, or C, so see if you can identify which is which. So here are the results. Are you ready? So next up, I want to show you some frequency response charts. So without getting too technical, the vertical axis represents loudness measured in decibels or dB, while the horizontal axis measures the frequency of the speakers measured in hertz. So this graph is essentially showing you the loudness of each frequency. So in summary, what this graph is saying is that even though the upfiring can produce the same sounds as the in-ceiling speakers, it's not as dynamic as the in-ceiling speakers. And below the crossover point of 200 Hz is where it begins to diverge and roll off. Now here's a graph of the in-ceiling versus elevation speakers. As you can see, they more closely track each other, but they won't be an exact match because of placement and reflection issues. So what's been my experience? Well, as I said before, I got my first introduction to Dolby Atmos via my Pioneer Elite. They were a huge upgrade to the system I had before that, and I really did feel like there was a new dimension added to my home theater. I remember listening to a lot of demos, but I still couldn't help but wonder why I wasn't as thrilled about it as some other people seem to be. Of course, I chalked this up to having Dolby-enabled speakers versus the in-ceiling speakers that others had at the time. But regardless, I was still happy with my setup because it sounded great. That was until I went to a Best Buy Magnolia showroom and listened to their in-ceiling speakers in person. So my advice to you is if you're happy with your upfiring speakers, don't do that. Just don't. So after that, I went about researching how I could install in-ceiling speakers, and I was lucky because this room made it possible. So after installing and comparing both of them, I can tell you that the biggest difference between the two are dynamic range and precision. What do I mean by that? Well, take the Dolby Leaf demo for example. Before, with the upfront speakers, I had a good impression that there was a leaf overhead moving throughout the room. When I played the same demo on the in-ceiling speakers, I could tell exactly where the leaf was supposed to be. The best way of describing it is like it felt like the soundstage had extended to the ceiling. So I could hear all the nuances of the effect much more than I could with the upfiring speakers. Another big change which people who have upfiring speakers may know is that you can always tell where the sound is emanating from. So because the sound is emanating from the floor standing speakers, you can always hear which speaker the sound is actually coming from. I mean, you still hear the sound overhead, but you're also aware of its source. Another issue is that the crossover for upfiring speakers is 180 Hz to my knowledge. And what that means is that everything below that is crossed over to another speaker to take care of. So you won't be hearing that sound overhead. So the Ready Player One demo I played is a great example of that because there was so much low frequency effect that was not present in the upfiring portion of the demo. The in-ceiling and the elevation speakers were crossed over at 80 Hz. Normally I cross over the in-ceiling speakers at 60 Hz, but I want them to have parity for the comparison, so they were both set to 80. And speaking of the elevations, these are as close to in-ceiling as I have ever heard. They're so close that the difference is pretty much insignificant. So my thoughts on the matter is, in-ceiling speakers is de facto the best way of experiencing Dolby Atmos, while elevation speakers are the best you can get without cutting holes in your ceiling. While if you're constricted on both of those, then upfiring is the best way of experiencing Dolby Atmos. The fact is, as with many things, each speaker type has their pros and cons. Atmos with each of these speaker types offer a significant upgrade over the traditional 5.1 setup that we're all used to, and they all create the atmospheric sound bubble to varying degrees. But as I said, they all have their benefits and pitfalls. So some of the pros for Dolby-enabled speakers are ease of access, because you can buy a module or a speaker with the Atmos portion built in, like these. There is no installation and they benefit from an all-in-one design. But on the flip side, its usefulness depends on the type of ceiling you have. So if you have a slanted roof, it just won't work, because it depends on having a flat reflective ceiling, which is 7.5 feet to 14 feet high. And because it's reflecting sound off the ceiling, it's not as precise as its counterparts. Plus, it also has a higher crossover, typically 180 Hz. So everything below that is handled by other speakers. So as far as the elevations are concerned, installing those are pretty easy. Plus, they tend to be very capable speakers. People have even used their traditional bookshelves and hooked them onto their ceilings. And because of that, it offers very dynamic and precise sound. And because you can mount them where you want, you have flexibility of placement. But conversely, the cons would be wire management for one, because having speakers at the apex of your ceiling begs the question, where are you going to put all those wires? Of course, you can buy things like cord channels from Cordmate, but that's an extra cost. And also, even though the installation is relatively easy, there may be some people who just don't want to drill holes in their walls. And there's also no getting around the presence of these speakers. They'll be very visible on the top of your walls. So that's a matter of personal preference, of course. As far as in-ceiling speakers are concerned, these are discrete and precise. There's also a significant amount of speakers to choose from various brands, with different prices and performance characteristics. But this comes at the expense of its complex installation process. Now, oftentimes people hire contractors to install these because they just aren't comfortable cutting 8-inch holes in their ceilings. So hopefully you're thinking, hey, this video was awesome. Why haven't I heard about this channel before? To which I'll reply, well, thank you. Thank you very much. But to answer your question, I just started doing these videos in 2018 and I plan to do a whole lot more. So make sure to hit that like button and that subscribe button, because there is a lot more to come. Until next time, this has been your friendly neighborhood Villaman saying peace.